Hi, my name is Jason Kang. I'm a full-stack developer working in South Korea. When we talked about the history of JavaScript, I told you guys how JavaScript is meant to make the web more interactive. So events are the ways for us to interact with the web so that we can have the full experience of a web page. There are many events in JavaScript, and events are triggered by actions. Some common ones are KeyboardEvent and MouseEvent. When you type in your ID and password to log in or click the login button, events occur. Today we're going to handle click events on these three A tags right here. And I said handle because the functions that deal with the events are called event handlers. If you take a look right here, I add the same class name called A underbar header. So if I add an event handler to the tags that has this class name, I can handle all of them at once. First, let's create app.js file. And we're going to let this index.html know that we're going to use JavaScript codes from app.js. And I add a script tag at the bottom of the HTML file to improve display performance. It takes such a long time to load a script, so we're going to make sure that our index.html load all the tags that we have created and then load our JavaScript file. And now we're going to use document.getElementsByClassName to get the elements that we want using the class name that we just talked about. If you watched the video in the earlier session, you're going to know the difference between ID and class. So now you know why we're using the getElementsByClassName method. So let's get to it. And now let's use console.log to make sure that we got the elements correctly. Use developer tool, you can check the log. There we have them right here. It kind of looks like an array, so I'm going to treat them like an array and add event handlers that we want. Let's take a look. And now let's add event handlers. So if I did this right, when I click those elements, I'm gonna see a text called clicked. Let's take a look. Yes, there we go. You see them right there. Now, if you look back to our index.html, there's a different class name called a header inactive. This one. So if you take a look, I'm gonna zoom in a little bit. The one that has a class name called aHeaderInactive is different color from the one that is not. So I'm going to use this class name to change the colors. So let's get to it. Take a look at this. This means that if a link has a class called aHeaderInactive, it gets rid of it once it's clicked. So when you click, you can see the color changes. But the problem is when you click this item right here, this one still remains active. So let's get rid of that as well. So with this event handler, you can see that color changes when you click it. But the problem is that the one had been active still remains active. So let's take care of that. This code right here means that if the tag doesn't have class name called aHeaderInactive, add that when click happens. So take a look. You can see the problem has been solved. But with this cursor like this, it doesn't look clickable, so let's change that. Let's go to our CSS file, add a cursor option. There we go. Now it looks a lot better. And that's it for today. As always, if you learn something specific, just leave them in the comments below so I can answer your questions. Thank you, and stay tuned.